CDS hook specification by HL7 enables EHRs to communicate to an external service and then show cards or clinical decision support alerts that are of relevance. My name is Dr. Sidharth Ramesh, and if you are new here, I'm a doctor by training, but I'm in health IT, and we go over everything health informatics related in this channel. If you stick around till the end of this video, you will learn how you can create your own CDS service that works with the HL7's CDS hook specification, and we'll actually be testing it out with the sandbox. So let's get started. So now the CDS hook specification is pretty straightforward. Every time the doctor does something in the EHR, you get a request to your CDS service, and then you are allowed to return these cards that can, for example, in this example, let's say they are ordering a medication. You can return a card that says, okay, this medication will cost $45 per month. And you can have a suggestion that says, okay, if you switch to this other medication, you will save this patient $7, right? And your CDS service here is what we are going to build today. So let's first click on try it here. And let's look at the sandbox and how this looks like. So this is the sandbox where there are a few CDS hooks already configured, and we will actually be configuring our own CDS hooks with this particular sandbox. Now, if you go to the patient view, we see here we have a card showing now seeing Daniel. Now this comes from a service that's already configured, and we can all look at the request and the response of what is available. So now let's start simple. So how do you make your own CDS hook service, and how do you add it to an EHR? So in this case, we are working with the sandbox, but this will be very similar if you're working with a real EHR like Epic or Cerner. So now they have an option here for you to add a CDS service. So now you need something called the discovery endpoint. So now what you can do is if we go back and read the CDS hook specification, there is a specific part here on how discovery works. So we are going to look at the version 2 and look at discovery. So if they make an endpoint, if they make a call here to /CDS services, you're supposed to respond with something that looks like this. Okay. Now this is basically you telling the client, in this case, this is the CDS client, what you support, which all types of hooks you support. So it could be a hook is basically when you open the patient or when you are prescribing a drug. So you are advertising to the CDS client what all you support. Okay. So now let's actually implement this. So we have our simple application here in Node.js, and we are using the Express server. You're interested in CDS hooks. Do you want to learn more about FHIR and health informatics in general and become an expert one day? I conduct one webinar every month to do just this. By signing up, you get access to the webinar, you get access to some exclusive content on our e-learning platform, and you get added to a Slack community with hundreds of people just like you. If that sounds like something you're interested in, there are limited seats only, so register now using the link in the description down below. Back to the video. And we already have a simple application here. So if I run this application, so I'm going to use VS Code here to run this. So I'm already running this on localhost 3000. Okay, so I have some debuggers set here. I'm just going to remove those. And if I go to localhost 3000, it says hello world. Okay, that's because we just have a basic setup here. Now what we first want to do is we want to expose our server out to the world, and we want to have this particular service work with our service, right? So let's say add CDS service. So technically this will work even if you use localhost, because this is actually using the browser to make all of these requests. But I will try and tell you how to make this work with the real EHR, right? So I'm going to use a service called Ngrok, and this will enable me to expose my port to the open, to the internet, right? So it has already configured, you know, port 3000, and it's forwarding all traffic that goes to port 3000. And if I get my endpoint. So this is my dedicated Ngrok endpoint. So you will be able to get this as well if you sign up for an account. I'm able to see the same hello world here. Okay. Now, all well and good, and you're also able to get a log of all the requests that are coming through here. So now what we need to do is we need to make sure our sandbox is able to see what we are returning, and then it should discover that we want a hook to be registered. Okay, so let's go back to the spec and let's look at what the response looks like. I'm going to copy paste this here and just I'm going to add another endpoint called CDS services. Request response. And I'm just going to say rest.json, this whole thing. Okay. Now here, there are a bunch of services. We don't want all of this. We just want to, you know, for the time being, work with the patient hook. So we have the patient view hook. So this gets triggered every time they open the patient view, and the ID here determines what API it calls. So what we need to do now is it'll first make a GET request to CDS services, and then the sandbox will now know that we have a hook that needs to be triggered whenever the patient is opened, and they will call CDS services slash this particular ID every single time that happens. So we also need to write another route here, and this time it's a post route. And let's not call it static patient greeter. Let's just call it patient greeter. So patient greeter, and let's say request response. And here, let's first take a look at what this looks like, right? So I'm going to say, and again, we want to use, we already have cores enabled. We have the body parser.json enabled. So it's able to parse the JSON for you. So you can just do res.json. Oh, sorry. We actually want the request. Request.body. And we will just see what this looks like. Okay. So we are doing a bunch of things here. So we are just saying the title of the CDS service. We are also having this thing called the prefetch template. So this lets the CDS client prefetch some data for us and then give it to us when this call is being made. So let's first register this. Okay. So if we look at our endpoint here, and if we just go to CDS service, now let's restart our server once. You see that we are able to actually see this patient view, static CDS, and there is a patient greeter, right? So this is exactly what the sandbox would do as well. So let's register this. Let's save this. And you see now that, so it did make a request to patient greeter. And that's because we registered it with our endpoint. So there is a patient greeter endpoint right here. Okay. Now we can actually inspect the body and see what this actually looks like. I am going to just hover over this here. So if we see, we have this thing called prefetch patient to greet. And this, if you realize, it's actually a FHIR resource. And that's because we asked it to return this patient to greet and we made this the current FHIR resource in context. So now let's look at what this looks like. Let's just return a CDS card that says hi to this particular patient. Okay. It's kind of like a hello world example. So let's take the body. So body.prefetch.patient-to-greet. So this is going to be our patient. And let's actually give this a type of patient. And let's import patient from fire/r4. Okay. So I have the TypeScript library called fire/r4 that will automatically type this. So I have the patient. So let's get the patient's name. That would be the patient's name. Let's just make sure there are no null errors here. So we got the patient's name. Now let's just say hello, name of the patient. Okay. And what we need to do here is we actually need to return a card. So now ChatGPT is being a little helpful today. And this is summary is patient greeting. But actually what I want to say here is I want to say the message. and allow detail, that's fine. And here we can put our CDS services name in the source. So we can say, for example, medblocks CDS demo service. We can have this as medblocks.com. And if you want, we can also have a URL of the logo here. So let's take a look at the response of the... Okay, so this is calling a CDS service. We want to look at how the CDS service response looks like. Let's look at... So if you, again, don't have any cards, you can just return like no cards. But we do want to display something. So icon, okay? So let's also include an icon here. This all comes in the source. And let's just get an icon from here. So let's quickly get this icon. Just copy that. All right. So we have our summary. We have our detail, which is both the same. It just says hello and the name of the patient. And we have the source. Okay. And this is just the thing that it returns. Okay. That's about it. So now let's restart our server. And let's remove this debugger endpoint and see if it worked. So now let's come back and come back to patient view. And ta-da! You get a nice little card here saying, hello, Daniel, from Medblocks demo service. And if you click on that, it goes to the website that you just mentioned. And it says, hello, Daniel, right here. Perfect. So now, how can we add a little bit more? So what we can do is we can add links to this card. So what if they want to open up, let's say, a website like Google, right? So right in the cards, along with all of this, you can also say links. And helping me, for example, we can say open Medblocks, but this could also be a smart app. It could be something more useful. So this is not a very useful alert here, but I'm just showing you how to do a demo, right? So let's again, go back and come to the patient view. And you see the button that shows up here. And if you click on this, it'll open up this website in another tab. Now, this is just scratching the surface of what CDS hooks and these cards can actually do. To see a more comprehensive example, I'll show you something pretty cool. So here I'm selecting a trademark drug. So there is a CDS hook that goes to this thing called CMS price check. And again, you can check the API requests that go and that come back in the network. You can see everything. So if I just do this, if I come back here, you can see everything that happens and you can just inspect this. Now, what this returns is it actually returns a card that says change this drug to generic. So this ondansetron drug, instead of giving the brand name of Zofran, I can just change this to generic and I can save $1,000 for this patient. And all I need to do is click on this change to generic and it changes that particular drug. And now it tells me what the cost is again. So there are more options you can do with these cards. And we have a detailed blog in the description below, which you can use to go through all of this as well. But the CDS hook specification is out here. You can do a lot of really cool stuff with it. And we just saw how we can build our first CDS hook that works with the sandbox. Thanks for staying around and I'll see you in the next one.